Hello everyone, Treecks here, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. Last time I was here and I was trying to get eaten by some like-likes. I mysteriously got all my bombs and arrows back. I wonder what happened, as if I bothered to reset my inventory in the meantime. But anyway, we're heading towards Dungeon 6. As you can see, this little bog area over here, which is completely cut off of the rest of the world, is where it is. So you may wonder, how the hell are we supposed to get there? Because you might have seen in the Dark World, the moment we try to get to the entrance to that place, it is a dead end there. Just like this... Good way, spawning right on that rock. That's better, even though I did almost spawn on a bush. But okay, just like this place, the sixth dungeon is also one we cannot access directly from the Dark World. In fact, this location, this sixth warp spot over here, is actually only accessible with this warp bird. Making it the only thing in this game that requires the flute and the warp bird. I did promise you there was going to be one thing in this game which actually requires this form of warping. It's actually this one. It is the only way in here, in this evil swamp, where it always rains. And the birds are turned into pterodactyls for some reason. But okay, of course there's also stuff here. We are not just here for a dungeon, there's also some other entrances here. Dungeon is over here, by the way, but still, we're not doing this quite yet. First we want to go in this cave to the left. Since we have not been here yet. Technically, we could have gone here earlier, but I thought might as well wait until the dungeon to get all the other stuff too. First one being a piece of heart. In fact, we only have three more to go after this one. We're actually building our final heart container with pieces of hearts, because the other two are from bosses, so only three more pieces of heart to go. And guess what? There's a suspicious spot here, this little outcropping over here. Suspicious. Let's return to the light world here. And let's spawn on another rock. What the hell? Okay, apparently we need to go all the way into the corner, then we can avoid the rock. Once again, we are on another ledge we cannot access otherwise. Aha! Of course there's something here. And guess what? It's immediately the next piece of heart. Very easy block pushing puzzle, so it should not scare you. Thank you very much. Only two more to go. Both of them are actually in the vicinity of the final dungeon, so and this is what we're going to end with for now. Okay, apparently that was in the wall. So let's move our invincibility frames. Come on. Move to the middle of the portal and we can go back in. Okay, there we go. Okay, with both of the pieces of hearts taken care of, there's still one more cave over here, which actually does not have anything required. It is a great fairy fountain, so therefore it is not useless. Okay, with that said, time for a dungeon. Time for one of the most complicated dungeons, in fact. I know I called Ice Palace somewhat confusing, but this place is even worse. Hey, we know the symbol. A thunder symbol. Don't we have anything that resembles that? Yeah, look at this ether medallion. The exact same symbol. Aha! You guessed it. For Misery Mire, ether medallion required. Welcome to Misery Mire. This location, I must thank the randomizer for teaching me how this place works, because before I ever played the randomizer, I actually really got confused by this place constantly. I feel I've learned how it works now. First of all, hookshot required in order to get in here, as you can see. However, also because of the randomizer, I actually found out there's another way in. The hookshot is actually not required to get in here. Because, as you may remember, we have this boots jump trick that I used in Skull Woods a couple of times. We can actually implement that here too. It's a little bit hard to get room for it. I never claimed it was easy. But if you actually manage to get enough room between you and this block, you can actually use this jump method in order to exit the place as well. Like I said, thanks to the randomizer, because that actually taught me that the moment I have found the Pegasus shoes, but not the hookshot yet, the game still claimed Misery Mire was actually already accessible. And after some research, I actually found out apparently the Pegasus shoes is enough to access Misery Mire. Interesting. But okay, this place actually introduces us to Wiz Ropes for the first time, as you can see. They return from the first game. Luckily, they're not as annoying in this game. What is annoying is this center room in this place, because this is definitely one of the rooms that confused me a lot back in the day. But after playing a lot of randomizers, I should know how this works. There are blue bags here across this room, so we first need to find the switch before we can actually do stuff. First, we want to go to the top right of the dungeon in order to get the key items out of the way. And I'm not just talking about dungeon keys. There's going to be a lot of them, but also the map and the compass, of course. And after a long set of corridors that takes us through most of the dungeon already, we find the key at the end. So, let's move on back, because of course, there is more. This place is going to resolve around getting a lot of keys at first, before we actually move into the bulk of the place. Let's go right now, because more stuff needs to be grabbed. Let's go in here first. Okay, let's not go in here. I want that chest, the stupid blue packs. Okay, let's grab the key in this room then, because there's a switch under that skull. Can just damage eat our way there, but we can also use one of our invincibility items. Push the switch and grab the key from this chest. Okay, so another key in the skull over here. Okay, that's three already. Okay. Let's go up here. I was claiming I know this place inside out now, but I'm already doubting myself now. But I think I'm still going the right way. First we want to go here. Because we obviously want to make our way to a switch in order to get these blue packs out of the way that are across the entire dungeon, as you can see. And this room actually has that switch, so might as well press it as soon as possible. There you are. Okay. Another key in this skull over here. So don't skip out on that. So, now we can finally do some stuff in the dungeon. Getting all of the key items and such. Okay, we can go through this door over here. You don't necessarily have to, but I think in this case this is better. You can save a key here, technically, but it's a long way around if you do, so might as well just use it. There's plenty of keys in this place. I want you, but you're already away. I'm not going to bother chasing you across the spikes. So let's just move on. Okay, for this room we want to go back to the main room, because this one actually connects to the main room again. And with the blue packs down now, we can actually do a little bit more here now. Most of all, there's a key here. With the blue packs down, we can actually access this switch, and that will have a key in a chest. Let's move on here now, I think. So remember the compass is this way. No, this is where the big key is. Might as well grab that one first, now that we're here. Yeah, the compass is also this way, but it is actually a little bit later on, so might as well do this part first. Okay, key, thank you. Go down here, because I'm pretty sure this is where we need to go. No. It is where the chest with the big key is, but this is not where you access it. This is just a little balcony where you can see where it is. And that's not really helping us. Okay, we want to go north for the other stuff, but let's go south first, like I said, because this corridor is where eventually we'll end up getting the big key, so I might as well do that quickly. Hey, I didn't get electrocuted by the berries this time. That's a first. obviously don't want to fall in this hole over here. We find some torches. Behind some blocks. And the same deal here. Something smells like a puzzle here. And there's a Sarasha blah 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 tile here. Treecks, it is I, Sarasha la 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 la, the Elder. Set the four torches alight, and the way ahead shall surely open. I don't need your advice to see that those torches were a puzzle, it's pretty obvious. There's way too many whiz ropes in here, what the hell? Okay, apparently they don't want to respawn. I do want to get rid of them, because it can be quite annoying if you start solving this puzzle, so... But what we obviously want to do is light all four torches, get out of my face. So, smart idea is to first push all the blocks around, because the torches won't stay lit, of course, and... The only way you can do this quick enough is if the blocks are already out of the way. And hopefully the whiz ropes won't hinder you. Once you do, you can quickly go in these niches, light all four torches. And if you're in time, you can hear an earthquake will start moving. Yeah, this takes a while. The torches are even already out. But hey, the puzzle is already solved officially, so... Hey, this room is a little bit bigger now. Well, there's only one thing of interest here. This hole over here. And hello, chest with big key. Okay, with that out of the way, we can move our way towards the things that are still on the right side of the dungeon. Let's get those out of the way quickly first. Okay, where am I? Okay, this is where I am. In that case, we want to go here, here, back to the main room. Okay, we do need to go around, because we want to go to the rooms to the right, but as you can see, it's blocked off from here, so... Unfortunately, we do need to go around. But you can do like this, if you go to the center northern room. You can actually get back to this room we've already seen before. From here we can go in here. Okay, we're at the lower part of the main room again. So let's make our way towards the right side of the dungeon now. We've been there briefly, found the chest we couldn't grab because of the blue packs being up. But now that we have the big key, we can also take care of the big chest here, of course. Might as well do that first. Okay, this room can be challenging because, as you can see, the floor will start to crumble here. So we need to make our way across that bridge quite quickly. Don't be afraid for the eye lasers here, they can be easily avoided. But okay, now to solve that puzzle of the collapsing bridge. It is actually impossible to get to that bridge quick enough while just running. The key is using the hook shots, but it will actually only work if you're quick enough with that too. What the hell? Okay, let's not be an idiot this time. There we go. Is that so difficult? Okay. What is our reward? You've got the Cane of Samaria. If you use it strategically, the mysterious cane will be of tremendous help. Oh, what is not a help is this dialogue, because it's not saying what this item does. The Cane of Samaria is actually a block on demand. If you use it, it will cause magic, of course, but you can actually summon a block that you can then push around. It is something we can actually use for pressure switches whenever we don't get a statue or something. Puzzles like that. That's actually something you use it for, but it does have more uses. Okay, let's finally get the map. Something I've been going for a while now, but I'm getting sidetracked a lot in this place. As you can see, most of the place we've already done already. Yeah, that's what you get if you place a chest like this after some blue packs, and then giving me a lot of other things to do. But this is how the place looks. Most of it takes place on the first basement floor, as you can see. There's also a second basement floor, as you can see, and... Might as well take a look at that quickly. Because you may guess that's where the end is. Let's make our way there. Okay, this is the corridor where the big key was, but let's move on this corridor, this time heading north. Like I explained, the compass is there. Something I probably should have picked up earlier, but like I said, I always have trouble traversing this place, so excuse me if I'm not taking the most optimal route through this place. It's not my favorite dungeon, if it isn't obvious. This is where we're heading. The boss is on the first floor, or the first basement floor, I mean. So you might think that is what we're heading in order to access it. However, if you try to go there directly by going to the adjacent rooms, you will find out it is actually not that simple. The rooms are not connected directly. Going through this key door will teach you that end with a warp portal. And that warp portal is actually our way towards the second basement floor of this place, which we first need to do. And that is our ticket towards the boss. So don't trust the map in this case, or the compass. Because there's no direct route towards the boss. First we need to go through this room. You don't actually have to use the warp portal there. You can actually also go through the rooms on the right of the dungeon. It will also lead you here. Okay, we're back in this long corridor. Only this time we end with a staircase going down to the dark part of the dungeon, like I always call it. The second basement floor. Where most of the Cane of Samaria puzzles are going to be taking place. Okay, if you have a spare key, you can go in here for some loot. Not a whole lot. We've seen rupee rooms that are a lot more formidable in value. But okay, first Cane of Samaria puzzle. As you can see, this is a pressure switch. Only this room won't give you anything to push on it. But we have something we can put on it ourselves. Okay, oh yeah, this room. First, get rid of the Stealthos enemies here. Bam! Missed. Would have been fun. But no, I was not allowed. Stop eating my magic. I don't think I've addressed that yet, but these anti-fairies, if they hit you, they don't only take your hearts, they also take some magic away from you. There's also a reason not to get hit by these anti-fairies. It's not a whole lot. If you get hit by them enough times, you eventually run out of magic, and especially in these later dungeons, that can be quite annoying. Because, as you may notice, we actually need a whole lot of magic. And I also need a switch to be pressed. Where do I find one? Oh, there's one. So, let's go take care of. There's nothing really too much here, so. Only on the left side of the room, so let's hit the switch. And on the left side of the room, as you can see, is a cracked wall. This one is actually for another rupee room, I think. Pretty sure there's nothing required here. Yeah, this is just for rupees. Stay away from me, didn't invite you here. Okay, let's go down. Apparently you can't push the block. Would have been nice if you can push the block game. And I also want this anti-fairy, because I'm running low on health again. Yeah, the game knows you probably have the blue mail by this point, so despite having double defense, you usually still get hurt a lot here. Hey, this is mean. But luckily the game has a solution for that. We can go in the room to the north by bombing the wall, and there we find another switch. Pretty easy puzzle. Okay. Oh, not... I always get hit by these things. What I actually want is some magic. I don't really need it for the boss, but still, I'd like to have some magic at least. Getting a little bit low on magic, and I don't want to waste my potion quite yet. And the packs are also up here. But I think there's a switch behind this wall, so... Yeah. Come on! I'm completely out of magic now. Well, there's a little bit. But... Okay, I'm going to assume right before the boss I'm going to get a jar. A large one, hopefully. Okay, I'll just go in without it. After beating him, I will heal automatically anyway. Okay, here we have Vitreous, if I pronounce it correctly. It's actually one of the few bosses I actually always forget the name, but I believe it's Vitreous or something. And it's a pretty standard boss. Just a large eyeball with a couple of smaller eyeballs, which will try to launch at us. Which we can pretty easily take out with our sword. As you can see, they don't really move too fast, so really easy to take them out. Do be careful for the lightning attack the big eyeball sometimes uses. You can see it coming because of him coming out of the water a little bit. You can see his upper half will color in a little bit. That way you can see he's about to launch a lightning attack at you. But anyway, once all the small eyeballs are taken out, the big one will come into the arena and will start bouncing around really slowly, making it really easy to hit him. Yeah, I can't help it. The bosses in this game are really easy. With the exception of a couple. Even though he is killing me, because... What the hell? Seriously? I'm in the middle of a story how the bosses in this game are easy compared to other Zelda games. I managed to die against this guy. I know I didn't go in full health, but still. Let's just grab the heart container. Apparently I need it. Despite my blue mail, I die quickly. And crystal number 6. Out of 7. Only one more to go. Let's see what this girl has to say. That can help us in our adventure. I'm not going to bother reading the first line because it's the same one every single time. Now it starts. Ganon captured us because he couldn't break the seal of the sages with his power alone. Yeah, we noticed. And then, using the wizard Agahnim as his pawn, he drew us to the Dark World. After cracking the seal with our powers, he sealed us inside of these crystals. He then gave us to his loyal monsters, but Ganon didn't plan on you getting this far. Now, Princess Zelda is waiting for you inside of Turtle Rock. Please hurry! May the way of the hero leads to the Triforce. And hell yeah. Okay, luckily this place is over with. The final dungeon on the Dark World Death Mountain called Turtle Rock, as we already learned in the very first dungeon, is where Princess Zelda is. The final maiden crystal is going to house Princess Zelda. Once again, I'm not going to move again, because it's the end of the episode. Unfortunately, there are no bump enemies and likewise kill me this time, so... Treecks out. Later, folks. Thanks for watching, and see you next dungeon!